Now to our NewsHour Shares, something interesting that caught our eye. Ray Stanford has been looking for dinosaurs in creek beds and rivers for more than 30 years. Despite being a self-taught tracker, Stanford is something of a legend among paleontologists. As the NewsHour's Pamela Kirkland reports, 6 years ago, he made his biggest discovery to date.
There's part of a track down to the lower right, too.
When it comes to tracking dinosaurs, Ray Stanford is a natural.
The small angle suggests a rather high speed.
Stanford is a self-taught paleontologist, known for his talent for finding dinosaur fossils from the Cretaceous era, 140 to 65 million years ago. In 2010, while visiting his wife Sheila, an information specialist at NASA's Goddard Space Flight Center, he noticed a loose rock.
So this is the theropod track that led to, ultimately, the grand discovery.
On a separate visit, 2 years later, a rock on the hillside, not far from the first track he found, caught his eye.
If you had told me this, I would never have believed it. I was going to find something like this.
This time, it was the footprint of a nodosaur, the Cretaceous period's version of an armadillo. Beneath the ground, there were more tracks Stanford couldn't see. After years of analysis, it turns out he'd stumbled upon one of the best fossil trackways in the world.
Over 100 tracks, nearly 40 mammal tracks of at least three and probably five species of mammals, at least three species of dinosaur tracks, and probably two or three species of flying reptile tracks.
At least 110 million years ago, these dinosaurs, sauropods and nodosaurs, small mammals, and flying reptiles like the pterosaur, crossed paths on the 8.5-foot slab of sandstone. Because none of the prints overlap, experts think the tracks occurred over the course of a few days or hours. They remained untouched until now.
Where it actually pulled up the mud when it came out.
This replica is displayed in Goddard's Earth Science Building in Greenbelt, Maryland. The original sits in a warehouse for further study. If not for Stanford, the discovery might have been lost to construction. At the time, NASA had planned to build on the site.
I had walked by that place probably 30 or 40 times, and I had no idea there was something so cool right there.
Compton Tucker is a climate researcher at NASA and oversaw the excavation of the 4-ton stone. NASA tapped Tucker for his experience working on archaeological digs to find buried ruins.
We found where the sandstone was. We organized a team of volunteers to come in on weekends, and we dug up all of the rocks we found in our survey, and one of those rocks is the amazing rock which has the track Ray Stanford found.
These people are used to looking into space, not into ancient time looking down.
Stanford has been looking at tracks for over 25 years, thanks to his 10-year-old son's curiosity in dinosaurs.
Joel, who at a secondhand bookstore said, "Daddy, let's get this book on tracking dinosaurs," and we began to find dinosaur tracks in the stream, although we'd read another book that said nothing had been found in the D.C., Maryland area.
Since then, Stanford has tripled the number of dinosaurs and winged reptiles identified in the state of Maryland. One of his finds, a hatchling of a baby nodosaur, the only hatchling of an armored dinosaur in the world, sits on display at the Smithsonian National Museum of Natural History.
This is my favorite footprint, possibly, of all of them.
He and his wife, Sheila, estimate they've collected over 1,000.
In the middle of this, we have the adult theropod dinosaur.
For Stanford, fossil hunting is second nature.
It's a gift. It's a habit that grows. The more you do it, the better you get at it.
After unearthing his largest find, the 79-year-old is still searching for the next big discovery.
You get addicted, and I confess, you just keep on tracking.
For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Pamela Kirkland in Greenbelt, Maryland.
Finally.